Thank you very much. Thank you for the invitation. First of all, I want to apologize for my dress code, but unfortunately my luggage is still lost somewhere in the world.
You were not the only one.
So, today we speak about ciliary muscle electrostimulation to restore accommodation. And this treatment is a completely new approach to treat the presbyopia because it's based on ciliary muscle stimulation. Electrostimulation in general is a passive induction of muscle contraction using electro inputs. It's mainly used for muscle re-education, and especially in physiotherapy or orthopedy or gynecology. And in ophthalmologists, there are already articles about electrostimulation and eye, especially used for optic atrophy and retinal degenerations with no side effects. In electrostimulation and presbyopia, there are no items yet. So our purpose is to evaluate the efficacy of this new method to restore accommodation with a treatment based on contact lens and generator. The treatment is in topical anesthesia, and the concept is that the crystalline lens increase more and more the volume and the weight during the time, and the ciliary muscle cannot support anymore the weight of the lens, so resulting in a loss of elasticity of the lens, and people would start with glasses start to weaken more and more the ciliary muscle, which start to become lazy. The inclusion criteria were people between 40 and 50 years old, all of them were emmetropic or with a small amount of hyperopia, and with early presbyopia with a maximum of plus 150. We excluded those with epilepsy and those with pacemaker, the pseudophakis or people with ocular pathologies, all of people with drugs which could influence the accommodative response, the neuropathics, those with demyelinating pathologies, and those with vascular diseases which could influence the blood influx to the ciliary body. The ciliary body electrostimulator device is already CE mark and is made by a generator plus a cable and a contact lens and a syringe which is optional. The contact lens is born onto the eye with topical anesthesia. And there is also a small suction, which is to maintain stable the lens and center into the eye. The treatment is about 8 minutes per eye, and after the treatment, you have to release the suction and to remove the contact lens and to put artificial tears. The lens is 20 millimeters diameter in polycarbonate and contains 40 millimeters electrodes with no contact to the cornea, only on the pupil conjunctiva. And the four cables are connected from the core of the contact lens to the electrostimulator by male-female jacks. The passive exercise of the ciliary body increases more and more the contraction strength and efficacy of the muscle, and is based by 2 seconds of contraction followed by 6 seconds of rest and so on for the 8 minutes, in which the electrostimulator irrigates in square wave biphasic compensated microcontinuous current. The treatment can be done more laterally or bilaterally, and during the treatment the patient can feel a small tactic effect on the lids or in the whole eye, but no painful. We published this article on September in Journal of Refractive Surgery with our preliminary results, which consisted in better near vision of almost one character at 40 and 70 centimeters. Also, reading speed time decreased, and people could read more words in a minute and in less time. Also, contrast sensitivity was better, and also the characters on dim light condition with 50% of the lights off. Also, the weight test was better on about 6 centimeters of approximation of the nearest point, We also studied with a quantitative test objectively. We found the good results, but no very good reproducibility inter-tests. So with the UBM, we looked at what really happened after the treatment, and after a cycle of treatment, we found that there was an increasing of the lens thickness during the maximum accommodation, and decreasing of the anterior and posterior ray of curvature, especially in the anterior ray, which decreasing on an average of -0.20 millimeters, while the lens thickness increased on about 0.1 millimeters. Also, in maximum accommodation, the spherical aberration totally decreased, so it was more negative. And with the OPD scan, we also found the internal negative aberration, spherical aberration more negative. So we wanted also, of course, to find if there was an inside effect, and we studied the corneal endothelium, and there was no change in pleomorphism, polymegatism, and number of cells. And also with the tracing, we looked at the dysfunctional lens index, if the treatment was cataractogen. No, of course, no problem also in Sheffield camera. So the limits of the treatment is, of course, that if you treat people with more than 50 years old, you cannot have the same result, even if you can treat them, but of course they cannot remove glasses after 51, 52 years old. So based on our preliminary result, we can suggest to do an attack dose of almost 4 treatments within the 2 months, and then one treatment to maintain the effect every 2 or 3 months, depending, of course, on the age of the patient. So, taking in account all the presbyopia option, we can say that there are a lot of options, as we can see also today and tomorrow, but every treatment is less or more aggressive on the cornea, on the lens, on the sclera, and all the treatments are pseudo-accommodative, and not they don't work on true accommodation like this treatment. So of course the people between 50 years old and 45 are the main, it's very difficult to correct in refractive surgery, and with this treatment, which is less invasive, of course, is safe, and you can delay early presbyopia. Of course, we are in the starting, and several upgrades and optimization of the parameters, like time, the voltage, or the contact lens diameter, can increase the results, and combining this treatment with maybe presby drops or bioptic procedure like scleral procedures will bring in future to better improvising results and rejuvenating accommodation in presbyopia. Thank you.